A lot of y'all probably don't even know this car was ever made, nor was on the racetrack. Yeah, here's Kevin Harvick's 2008 Penske Platinum Chevrolet Impala. Howdy, folks, it's Diecast Buffet here again with an incredibly awesome, rare, and I tell you what, special Kevin Harvick diecast. I tell you what, a lot of people probably didn't even know this car was ever made, nor was it ran on the racetrack, right? Well, the Penske Platinum program cars, I tell you what, in 2008, this car is one of the most detailed COTs of the year, if not the most detailed. It is easily one of my all-time favorite Kevin Harvick paint schemes. The detail and the just transitions and all kinds of patterns, and I mean, this car is so freaking beautiful, it's incredible. So before we get the car out of the box, make sure to give it a big thumbs up, helps out the channel tremendously, and subscribe if you want to see more. Let's go ahead and get this 2008 Penske Platinum Chevrolet Impala out of the box. Alrighty, folks, right out of that good old box, and I tell you what, man, look at this paint scheme. I mean, you got the piston over here, you got these transitions, it looks like a freaking intro to it, like a CBS primetime show or something. I mean, look at all the freaking blue, the silver, the black. I mean, this car is remarkably detailed. Look at that gloss. That is basically a near mint gloss. I mean, You just don't find that anymore on these cars. I mean, this is a car that was protected in the box. Of course, after this video, it is going back into... it's going into the acrylic die-cast case to protect it from dust and all that good jazz. You know, UV rays and all that stuff. Of course, over here on the hood, you got Penske Platinum, our ultimate clean. You got the Shell logo. And I just love these paint schemes, right? And it's funny how this car reminds me so much of his 2010s Bush cars. You know, the detail, the transitions, the shadows, all that good stuff. This car is, I bet it was definitely a chore to design, but wow, is it beautiful. So you got the red bow tie there. Woo! Check that out. Yellow Impala SS. Love that. That is beautiful. Got the 29 right there. Got RCR. This is, of course, when Kevin Harvick was with the Richard Childress program, and a lot of people who might be just following the sport, Kevin Harvick was basically Richard Childress Racing. He was the guy. He had a lot of up and down years. They brought over Jeff Burton. They still couldn't get it turned around. But, you know, late in Kevin Harvick's stint at RCR through 2010 to 2013, he really picked it up. And heck, he may or may not have won a couple Coke 600s as well. So you got Goodyear Gatorback, you got Mel Moog, Rebesto's Wix Comp, Sunoco, whatever that is down there, JE. But look at the freaking detail. Like, even down here on the splitter, like above it, right, where the brackets are, you could just see that detailed paint scheme. I mean, this is the stuff that I freaking love. I love detailed race cars. And we're going to get a little bit of a closer look here. Check this out, guys. I mean, just stunning. Just stunning looking race car. And I think this was not like a promo or any of that BS. No, this was an actual racing release. And judging from the NASCAR 60th anniversary logo right there, I'm not sure when this car was ran. I don't know if it was I think it's actually the NASCAR Salutes logo as well. I don't know. Was this ran at like one of the Coke 600 or the whatever, the 400 at Daytona? I'm not too sure. Of course, you got Kevin Harvick right there, Coca-Cola. Remember when Kevin Harvick was sponsored by Coca-Cola? Yes, that was a long time ago. We got SKF. I think that's Schick. You got Road Loans. Never heard of a Road Loan. Got Dickies right there. You got Team Realtree, Reese's. I also have his 2008 Reese's Chevrolet. And I also have his 2010. Still missing that 2009. Now, I don't know if they ran a Penske Platinum car in 2009 or 2010. I don't know if they made a diecast for it. I don't know. But I do know for 2007 and 2008, I have those versions. And this one is remarkably better than the 2007. Got Shell, Penske, Platinum, our ultimate clean. Got Ream right there. And got Snap-on. Got the piston pumping over there like the Energizer Bunny. Got, Champion, Sherwin-Williams, safety clean. Iconic number 29 right there. Of course, you got NASCAR, Sprint Cup Series there, Mechanics Order, Holley 3M, DirecTV, USG, EA Sports, Dow Chemical, Denso, Stant, Jegs, Goodyear. And of course, over here to the caboose of this diecast, you got our ultimate clean once again. I guess that's their slogan with this. Maybe that was their year slogan for their 2008, program. Got to, of course, got Penzel, Shell, Penzel once again. The decal right here is a little bit rough around the edges, which is expected with a full wrap like this. But I tell you what, man, this thing is absolutely stunning, man. I mean, they even got the Shell and Penzel logos on the freaking winglets, bro. Wow. Red bow tie right there. I mean, this diecast, I'm telling you, man, this freaking diecast is just absolutely incredible, man. And I remember picking up this car. It was a lot, right? I bought, I think it was 2015. They had this car. They had the 2008 Reese's car with the Kevin Harvick joint. And they had his 2007 Gen 4, his 2007 COT primaries, his 2007 Gen 4 Reese's car, and his 2007 Penzel Platinum 07 COT. Yes, COT. So that car is pretty uncommon to get nowadays, and so is this. I mean, just look at that freaking gloss. I mean, just look at this, man. This is what a freaking diecast should look like. Detailed paint scheme, all these different colors. I mean, could you imagine this running like at a Knight Richmond race or something? I mean, good God almighty. And also, notice that little 3 right there. That's really cool. For the newer cats out there that don't know, they ran that little 3 there for, you know, in memory and tribute to Dale Earnhardt, because essentially the 29 car, as soon as Kevin Harvick joined RCR's Cup program after the unfortunate events of the 01 500, the 3 went to the 29, and then when Kevin Harvick flew the coupe and after 2013, the 29 became the 3 car when Austin Dillon jumped on board. So they carried the number 3 in honor and memory of Dale Earnhardt, and I thought that was freaking awesome. And you can see it on all of his diecasts, pretty much. I don't think I've ever seen a Kevin Harvick Richard Childress Racing car without the 3. Of course, you got the 29 right there, the yellow, black, and a very dark red. But I tell you what, man, stunning paint scheme. And we've seen some Penzel Platinum cars, I think, with Joey Logano. But I tell you what, man, I wish they would just run this car again. Honestly, like, you don't even have to make it a throwback. Like, this car was, like, so, I would say, ahead of its time, honestly, back in 2008, that you could really run this same paint scheme again on a Gen 7 or Gen 6. And to be honest with you, it still looked fantastic underneath the lights at maybe like a Charlotte race or something, you know. You got our Ultimate Clean. Heck, I would even say maybe a Kansas night race, you know. Just one of those good 1.5 mile events, and definitely a cool paint scheme to check out during practices. And I tell you what, next year we better have freaking practices, bro. I mean, if we don't have qualifying, we don't have practices, I'm not going to be the happiest cat in the alley, I'll say. But I tell you what, man, this diecast, stunning. And to think, this is an alternate paint scheme that was produced in 2008. I don't know how many Harvick cars they made in 08. I know they made the primary Shell Penzel, the Reese's car, the Penzel Platinum. I don't think they made a real tree car. I could be wrong on that, but I tell you what, this thing, absolutely stunning, and probably my favorite car from 2008. Like, the actual diecast releases, this is no doubt about it one of the top 3, if not number 1. Stunning looking car. Thank y'all so much for watching the video. Make sure to give it a big thumbs up, like, comment, and subscribe. Of course, tell me what y'all think about this very rare 2008 Kevin Harvick Penzel Platinum Chevrolet Impala. Very, very fortunate and blessed to get it. Of course, I got it when it wasn't that rare. And, well, it was still uncommon, but it wasn't, like, super rare when I picked it up, luckily. So, anyways, folks, hope you're having a great day out there. Like, comment, subscribe. Of course, hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of my new episodes of diecast reviews, NASCAR gameplay, post-race reactions, even so unscripted diecast racing known as the NASCAR Dornice Cup Series. With all that being said, folks, have a great one. Diecast Buffet, signing off.